What's up, guys? Welcome to the Troll Network. Check it out. Have a good one, guys. Enjoy.
Wladimir Klitschko was born on Thursday, March 25th, 1976, in a city now called Semey in the Kazakh Soviet Socialist Republic, which was the second largest republic in the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. But by today's standards, he was born in the country of Kazakhstan to Wladimir Rodivoch Klitschko, who was a Soviet Union Air Force Major General who was posted as a military attaché to East Germany. The definition of a military attaché is an army officer serving with an embassy or attached as an observer to a foreign army. Klitschko Sr. was also responsible for the cleanup operation after the Chernobyl disaster and was later diagnosed with cancer, to which he sadly succumbed in 2011. By all accounts, Klitschko Sr. was a hardened communist and believer in the Marxist-Leninist version of communism. Wladimir Klitschko's mother's name is Nadezhda, and she worked as a flight attendant. Wladimir Klitschko began his training as an amateur boxer in Bravoy Olympic Reserve School in the late 1980s. Bravoy Olympic Reserve School is located in the city of Bravoy in the Kiev Oblast region in northern Ukraine. In the early 1990s, Wladimir Klitschko was trained in Poland's Gwardia Warsawia Boxing Club, where, if you believe the words of a former two-time Olympic gold medalist Jerzy Kuljev, Wladimir and his brother Vitaly used to quote-unquote demolish our boys. As an amateur, Wladimir Klitschko accumulated a record of 134 victories, 65 of which came inside the distance, which is a phenomenal achievement. Wladimir Klitschko also had only 6 amateur losses, which is even more phenomenal. For context, Lennox Lewis had an amateur record of 85 victories and 11 losses. That's almost twice as many losses as Wladimir Klitschko and not as many fights. For those people that are still skeptical, Deontay Wilder's amateur record stands at 30 victories and 5 losses. So, the bronze bomber Deontay Wilder racked up almost as many amateur defeats in 35 fights as Dr. Steelhammer did in 140 amateur bouts. Now, in 1993, Wladimir Klitschko participated in the Junior European World Championships in Salonika, Greece. Wladimir dominated his opponent in the first fight of the tournament, and the referee stepped in and stopped the fight and saved the Georgian by the name of Fakazad from sustaining further punishment. In his second fight of the championship, Wladimir Klitschko defeated a Romanian in similar fashion as his first foe, where the referee stepped in and put an end to the contest. The concluding confrontation of the tournament saw Wladimir Klitschko step in the ring against a Russian by the name of Sergei Lopatansky. Wladimir Klitschko prevailed in this fight and was awarded with the gold medal for his weight class, which had a limit of 91 kg or just over £200. In 1994, Wladimir Klitschko took part in the Junior World Championships in Istanbul, Turkey. In his opening bout of the tournament, Wladimir Klitschko bested a Romanian called Constantin. Interestingly enough, Constantin went on to compete in the 2000 Olympic Games in Sydney, where he was beaten by Samuel Peters. Now, Constantin did in fact turn professional, and the highlight of his career was winning the German International Heavyweight title twice and competing for the vacant WBO Intercontinental Heavyweight title. In his second bout of the tournament, Wladimir Klitschko defeated a fighter from Kazakhstan by the name of Rustan. In his third bout, Wladimir Klitschko bested a Russian by the name of Andriy Kambarov. In the final fight of the tournament, Wladimir Klitschko tasted defeat at the hands of a Cuban by the name of Michel Lopez, who fascinatingly enough went on to win the bronze medal at the 2004 Athens Olympic Games. So Wladimir Klitschko won the silver medal in the Istanbul tournament at the 200-pound weight limit. Wladimir Klitschko participated in the 1995 World Championships in Berlin. In his first fight, Wladimir Klitschko defeated a Russian called Igor after the referee saw fit to stop the contest. In his second fight, Wladimir Klitschko bested a Czech called Jan Bezvoda. In his third and final fight of this particular tournament, Wladimir Klitschko was defeated by a German gentleman by the name of Luan Karanski. Now, Luan went on to win the heavyweight bronze medal for Germany in the 1996 Atlanta Olympic Games, and turned pro and won the European heavyweight title and challenged for the WBO heavyweight world title. So Wladimir Klitschko walked away from the 1995 World Championships in Berlin empty-handed. But his failure in Berlin didn't deter Wladimir Klitschko, and in the same year, he entered the military world championships in Arica, Italy, where in his first fight, Wladimir Klitschko defeated a South Korean called Song Ji-jang. In his second scuffle of the tournament, Wladimir Klitschko defeated a familiar foe, a Russian by the name of Igor, who Wladimir had already bested in Berlin a few months prior. Wladimir Klitschko's third test of the tournament came against a Turk by the name of Sian Salim Sam. Now, Sian did in fact turn professional and had a professional record of 31 victories, of which 16 came by KO and 4 losses, all of which were by decision. Sian became the first Turkish boxer to win the professional European heavyweight championship above 140 pounds. Sian also won the WBC International Heavyweight title, the WBC Mediterranean Heavyweight title, and the European Heavyweight title. Now, Wladimir Klitschko defeated Sian in the penultimate fight and made his way into the final, where a familiar foe awaited, the German Luan Karanski, who had bested Wladimir Klitschko in Berlin a few months prior. But in this particular bout, Wladimir Klitschko went on to avenge his loss in Berlin and defeated the German and captured the gold medal. In 1996, Wladimir Klitschko moved up from heavyweight to super heavyweight and took part in the European Championships in Denmark, where in his first fight, Wladimir Klitschko defeated an Irishman by the name of Sheen Murphy via DQ in the second round. Now, I don't know why Sheen was disqualified, as it doesn't go into the details. In Wladimir Klitschko's second scuffle, he overcame an Azerbaijanian by the name of Adila Mahmadov when the referee called a halt to the contest in the third round. In his third fight of the tournament, Wladimir Klitschko came up against a Swedish man by the name of Attila Levin. Now, Attila did go on and become a professional boxer and raked up a record of 35 victories, 27 of which came by KO, and 4 defeats, all of which came by KO. Now, Attila's career highlights were challenging the giant Russian Nikolai Valuev, who at the time was 39-0. For the WBA Intercontinental Heavyweight title in 2005 and challenging Robert Hellenius for the WBO Intercontinental Heavyweight title and the European Heavyweight title. Now, Wladimir Klitschko defeated Attila, who won the bronze medal in this tournament. In the final of the European Championships, Wladimir Klitschko rumbled against a Russian by the name of Alexei Lezin. Now, Alexei Lezin went on to represent Russia in the 1996 Atlanta Olympic Games and won the bronze medal. But in this particular tournament, Alex Lezin captured the gold medal by defeating Wladimir Klitschko via points. So, Wladimir Klitschko walked out of the European Championships in Denmark with a silver medal. Now, in June 1996, Wladimir Klitschko participated in the Atlanta Olympics in the state of Georgia in the United States of America. In Wladimir Klitschko's first fight of the Olympic Games, he faced an American by the name of Lawrence Clay Bay. Wladimir Klitschko bested Lawrence Clay Bay via points. In Wladimir Klitschko's second scuffle of the Olympics, he faced a familiar foe in the shape of Attila Levin, who Wladimir Klitschko had defeated a few months prior at the European Championships in Denmark. The last time they had met, Wladimir Klitschko had won a points decision, but this time the referee stepped in and stopped the fight in the first round. Now, Wladimir Klitschko's third test of the Olympics came against a familiar foe, this time against the Russian Alexei Lezin, who had bested Wladimir Klitschko in the European Championships a few months prior. However, this time Wladimir Klitschko defeated Alexei Lezin and avenged his loss at the European Championships. Now, the final of the super heavyweight division in the Olympics was contested between Wladimir Klitschko and a Togan by the name of Pierre Wolfgram. Now, Wolfgram did in fact turn professional and faced Wladimir Klitschko in the pro game, but back to the Olympics, where Wladimir Klitschko won the fight and thus captured the gold medal for his country, Ukraine. After the Summer Olympics, Wladimir Klitschko turned professional with Universum Box Promotions in Hamburg under the tutelage of Fitz Sudneck. Wladimir Klitschko made his pro debut on November 16, 1996 at 20 years and 237 days old. The location of the bout was Hamburg, Germany. Now, Wladimir Klitschko weighed in at 220 pounds and was up against an Italian by the name of Fabian Meza. Now, the bout was scheduled for 4 rounds, but spoiler alert, Dr. Steelhammer didn't need 4 rounds. Now, Fabian came out aggressively and looked to take the confrontation to Wladimir Klitschko. The two traded power shots before a flurry of rights and lefts at around the 1 minute 11 second mark sent Fabian stumbling backwards hard into the ropes, and he kneaded to the count of 6 before getting off the canvas. However, the knockdown didn't deter Fabian and he charged back in for more, which he received in abundance as he was met with a sequence of punches finished off with an immense right hook. Now, the right hook sent Fabian crashing to the mat flat on his back and he smashed his head hard on the canvas. The referee waved an end to the bout without beginning a count and requested the doctors enter the ring. Fabian was ultimately able to get to his feet and walked out of the ring, and it was the first and only time Fabian fought outside the United States of America. Wladimir Klitschko's second pro bout took place just 14 days after his debut, this time in the Arena Nova in Austria on November 30th, 1996. Wladimir Klitschko weighed in at 221 pounds and his American adversary Exum Spate weighed in at 207 pounds. Now, don't get it twisted, Exum was at this point in his career a journeyman. His record stood at 8 victories, 30 losses and 2 draws. Now, Wladimir Klitschko began landing with haymakers near the end of the opening round that buzzed Spate. A flurry of punches from Wladimir Klitschko sent Spate to the canvas early in the second round. A right to the chin sent him crashing to the canvas again a minute later. Another combination from Wladimir Klitschko floored Spate for the third and final time at 1 minute 54 seconds as the referee stopped the fight without a count. Dr. Steelhammer's third professional bout came 21 days after his second one. It took place on 21st of December 1996, just 4 days before Christmas. The fight took place in Frankfurt, Germany, and Wladimir Klitschko's adversary was an American by the name of Bill Corrington. Now, Bill was a journeyman with a record of 10 wins and 12 losses with 1 draw. He was 33 years of age when he faced Wladimir Klitschko, so there was a 13-year age gap between the two fighters. The bout was scheduled for 4 rounds. Dr. Steelhammer won via TKO in the first round, and with that win, Wladimir Klitschko's record went up to 3 victories, all coming via KO. Wladimir Klitschko's fourth professional fight occurred on 25th of January 1997 and it took place in Stuttgart, Germany. Wladimir Klitschko's foe in this fight was an American by the name of Troy Wedia, who at the time of stepping in the ring against Wladimir Klitschko had a record of 6 wins, 1 loss and 1 draw. So he was by no means a journeyman. Now Wladimir Klitschko got him out of there in the 3rd round via TKO. Now Wladimir Klitschko's 5th fight as a pro came against an American called Carlos Monroe and it was scheduled for 6 rounds. It was Wladimir Klitschko's 2nd fight to be scheduled for 6 rounds. The fight took place in Cottbus, Germany. Wladimir Klitschko weighed in at 220 pounds while Carlos Monroe weighed in at 254 pounds, a whopping 34 pounds heavier than Dr. Steelhammer. Now, Monroe was deducted a point for excessive holding in the 4th round, so it looks like Dr. Steelhammer did learn a thing or two from this fight and Monroe was disqualified in the 6th round for a headbutt which cut Wladimir Klitschko on his left cheekbone. Less than 2 months later, Wladimir Klitschko was in the ring again, this time against an American by the name of Mark Young, who had a record of 15 victories, 33 losses and 1 draw. So he was a journeyman at this point in his career. The bout took place in Germany in a city called Aachen and the fight was scheduled for 6 rounds. Now, by this point, Wladimir Klitschko was 21 years of age and had celebrated his birthday after the Carlos Monroe fight. Now, Mark Young decided to retire on his stool after the 2nd round, thus bringing the contest to a close. Now, on May the 10th, 1997, in Frankfurt, Germany, Wladimir Klitschko faced another American, this time by the name of Mark Wills. Now, Mark Wills was an experienced fighter who was 36 years of age. This was Wladimir Klitschko's first fight to be scheduled for 8 rounds. However, Dr. Steelhammer needed only 1 and knocked out his American adversary, taking his pro record to 7-0. Wladimir Klitschko's 8th professional bout took place on the 13th of June 1997 in Western Germany against another American adversary. I mean, now you know why the American media never really warmed up to Wladimir Klitschko, because he keeps on facing and beating Americans. This contest was scheduled for 8 rounds and Wladimir Klitschko needed only 2, knocking out his American adversary Paul Ashley halfway through the 2nd round. Wladimir Klitschko's 9th professional bout came against a Mexican fighter by the name of Salvador Martial, who had a record of 21 wins and 11 losses and 17 of his victories coming via knockout. This bout took place just a fortnight after Dr. Steelhammer's previous bout, but it ended in a first round knockout. Dr. Steelhammer knocked the Mexican out in the first round. Dr. Steelhammer's 10th professional fight came against Gilberto Williamson, a 27-year-old American fighter, and the bout was scheduled for 8 rounds. The bout took place in Hagen, Germany, and Dr. Steelhammer was victorious via TKO in the third round. Wladimir Klitschko's 11th pro melee took place in Stuttgart, Germany on August 23, 1997. The bout was scheduled for 6 rounds, which was odd as Wladimir Klitschko's previous 4 fights had been scheduled for 8 rounds. Now, Dr. Steelhammer's foe for this particular bout was a 40-year-old Austrian by the name of Biko. At the beginning of the 5th round, Dr. Steelhammer's Austrian adversary's corner man declined to leave the ring, accusing Dr. Steelhammer of utilizing illegal tactics. After several warnings, the corner man persisted and refused to leave the ring, and thus the referee awarded Dr. Steelhammer the victory. Wladimir Klitschko's 12th fight as a professional came less than 1 month after his 11th and took place on the 20th of September 1997. The fight was scheduled for 8 rounds and took place in the city of Aachen, Germany, and Wladimir Klitschko's opponent was an American by the name of James Pritchard. Now, James Pritchard was 36 years old, so he was 15 years older than Dr. Steelhammer, but that did not deter Dr. Steelhammer, and Dr. Steelhammer stopped him in the third round of the fight. Wladimir Klitschko's 13th pro fight came against a Mexican by the name of Marcos Gonzalez and took place in a city in Germany called Cottbus. The fight was scheduled for 8 rounds, however, Dr. Steelhammer demolished his Mexican opponent by knocking him out in the second round. Wladimir Klitschko's 14th professional bout came on the 6th of December 1997 in Germany. The bout was scheduled for 8 rounds and Wladimir Klitschko's foe was an American by the name of Jerry Halstead. Now, Dr. Steelhammer came out of the blocks firing and knocked Jerry Halstead down twice in the opening round and then twice in the second round. Now, after the second knockdown in the second round, the referee waived the count and stopped the fight. This bout was Jerry Halstead's final bout as a professional boxer, so it could be argued that Dr. Steelhammer retired him. Dr. Steelhammer's 15th professional bout took place just 1 week after his previous fight. It was located in Hamburg, Germany on the 13th of December 1997 and was scheduled for 8 rounds. Wladimir Klitschko's opponent was a Slovakian by the name of Ladislav. Now, Dr. Steelhammer smashed the Slovak and won via TKO in the 3rd round. Wladimir Klitschko's 16th professional bout came 1 week after his 15th. It took place in Offenburg, Germany on the 20th of December 1997, so 5 days before Christmas. The bout was scheduled for 8 rounds and Dr. Steelhammer's adversary was an American by the name of Derek Lampkins. Now, Dr. Steelhammer annihilated his American adversary in the first round via TKO. Wladimir Klitschko's 17th professional fight took place in Stuttgart, Germany on the 14th of February, which of course is Valentine's Day 1998. Wladimir Klitschko's adversary was an American by the name of Marcus McIntyre, who at this point in his career had 15 victories and only one loss, so he was by no means a journeyman. This bout was special for two reasons, as firstly it was Wladimir Klitschko's first professional bout to be scheduled for 12 rounds and it was for the vacant WBC International Heavyweight title. Wladimir Klitschko won the fight in the third round by knocking Marcus McIntyre out and thus became the WBC International Heavyweight Champion. Wladimir Klitschko's 18th professional bout took place on the 13th of March 1998 in Hamburg, Germany, and was scheduled for 8 rounds, so his newly won WBC International Heavyweight title was not on the line. Wladimir Klitschko was facing an American by the name of Everett Martin. Now, this fight was Dr. Steelhammer's first professional fight to go the distance, and thus he won via unanimous decision. Wladimir Klitschko's 19th professional bout came against a man called Cody Koch and took place on the 23rd of May 1998. The bout itself was scheduled for 12 rounds and took place in Offenburg, Germany. Now, this was Wladimir Klitschko's first defense of his WBC International Heavyweight title. Cody Koch had a record of 25 victories and 1 defeat, so he was by no means a journeyman. Dr. Steelhammer annihilated the American by knocking him out in the 4th round and thus retaining his WBC International Heavyweight title. Wladimir Klitschko's 20th professional fight came on the 10th of July 1998 in Munich, Germany, and was scheduled for 12 rounds. Now, at this point in his career, Naji wasn't a journeyman and was actually undefeated, just like Dr. Steelhammer. Naji Shahid had a record of 16 victories and 1 draw. Naji Shahid was Wladimir Klitschko's first undefeated professional opponent, so it was a very dangerous fight for Dr. Steelhammer. But Dr. Steelhammer went in there and knocked the undefeated Naji Shahid out in the first round. Wladimir Klitschko's 21st professional fight took place less than a month after his annihilation of Naji Shahid. Wladimir Klitschko's opponent was an American by the name of Carlos Monroe. If that name sounds familiar, it's because Wladimir Klitschko fought him in his 5th professional bout. And of course, Carlos Monroe was disqualified due to headbutting Dr. Steelhammer. Now, this was Dr. Steelhammer's first professional fight on American soil. The bout itself was scheduled for 10 rounds and Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 235 pounds while Carlos Monroe weighed in at 260 pounds. The location of the bout was Marksville, Louisiana. Dr. Steelhammer revealed to the ESPN commentators before the fight that revenge was a primary motive for him taking the rematch. Dr. Steelhammer dominated the fight and landed a right hand in the 6th round, which dropped Monroe. Monroe got up at the count of 8 but chose not to continue, and thus Dr. Steelhammer was declared victorious. This was Carlos Monroe's last fight as a professional boxer, so Dr. Steelhammer retired him. So the least we can say is that Dr. Steelhammer did get his revenge. Dr. Steelhammer's 22nd professional bout came on the 19th of September 1998 and took place in Germany against an American by the name of Steve Pannell. The bout was scheduled for 10 rounds. Now, the bout itself was extremely dramatic as both Wladimir Klitschko and Steve Pannell hit the canvas in the first round. Wladimir Klitschko managed to knock out Steve Pannell in the second round. Dr. Steelhammer's 23rd professional bout came less than 1 month after his knockout of Steve Pannell, and it was against Eli Dixon. The fight took place in Germany and Dr. Steelhammer won the bout comfortably via knockout in the third round. Dr. Steelhammer's 24th professional bout came on the 14th of November 1998 in Munich, Germany. The fight itself was scheduled for 8 rounds. Dr. Steelhammer's opponent was an American by the name of Donnell Wingfield. Wow, that's 9 consecutive Americans that Dr. Steelhammer fought and beat. Dr. Steelhammer knocked out his American adversary Donnell Wingfield in the first round. Wladimir Klitschko's 24th professional bout was also his first in his home country of Ukraine. The bout took place in Kiev, Ukraine and was scheduled for 12 rounds. Wladimir Klitschko's foe for this particular fight was an American by the name of Ross Purity. Now, during the fight, Wladimir Klitschko was the far more active fighter. Wladimir Klitschko boxed more through jabs and through combinations to the body and the head, while Ross Purity covered up and continuously stalked Klitschko. Now, Wladimir Klitschko was winning the fight but didn't pace himself and punched himself out by the 10th round. Wladimir Klitschko went down with 30 seconds left in round 10, but the referee ruled it to be a slip. Wladimir Klitschko went down again in the final seconds of the 10th round. After watching Wladimir Klitschko take several powerful punches at the beginning of the 11th round, his trainer entered the ring and stopped the fight. It was Wladimir Klitschko's first professional loss, and what's worse is that he lost his WBC International Heavyweight title. Wladimir Klitschko said, "I was unable to control my emotions in front of my countrymen in Kiev. Usually I am able to stay cool inside the ring. In that night I wasn't. I didn't stick to my game plan. I wasted my energy and I wasted my punches. The loss hurt me like a deep scar, but I also gained a lot of experience. I feel matured by 10 years. What makes this loss even more devastating was that it was the first and only time Wladimir Klitschko fought in his native Ukraine." Wladimir Klitschko's 26th professional fight came just a little more than 2 months after his first pro loss. The bout took place in Stuttgart, Germany, against a man from Montenegro by the name of Zoran. I am not even going to attempt to pronounce his surname. Anyway, he was undefeated with a record of 14-0, so Dr. Steelhammer was thrust back in there against a dangerous foe. Dr. Steelhammer obliterated the undefeated Montenegrin in the first round via knockout. Dr. Steelhammer's 27th professional fight took place in Munich, Germany against a familiar foe. The familiar foe was Everett Martin, who Wladimir Klitschko had fought over a year ago. The bout took place on the 24th of April 1999 and was scheduled for 8 rounds. Dr. Steelhammer won via TKO in the 8th round. Less than 1 month later, Dr. Steelhammer was in the ring again, this time in Budapest, Hungary, against an American by the name of Tony La Rosa. The bout was scheduled for 10 rounds and took place on May the 22nd, 1999. Dr. Steelhammer decimated Tony La Rosa in the first round, winning via TKO. Now, Tony La Rosa did in fact manage to collect victories over some former world champions. Those victories included Trevor Burbick in 1999 and both Iran Barkley and Dwight Muhammad Kawi in 1998. Funnily enough, Tony's victory over Trevor Burbick came straight after his loss to Dr. Steelhammer, which shows that he was a pushover and was a really good, durable, solid fighter. Sadly, Tony La Russa died in 2008 at the age of 41 from an accident on the construction site he was working at, so rest in peace. Dr. Steelhammer's 29th professional bout came against a Zambian by the name of Joseph Chin Agu and took place in Dusseldorf, Germany, and was for the vacant WBA Intercontinental Heavyweight title. Wladimir Klitschko weighed in at 236 pounds and Joseph Chin Agu weighed in at 233 pounds. Now, Chin Agu quit on his stool after round 4, so Wladimir Klitschko won the vacant WBA Intercontinental Heavyweight title. Dr. Steelhammer's 30th professional fight came against a German gent by the name of Alex Schultz. The bout took place in Cologne, Germany and was scheduled for 12 rounds. This was Dr. Steelhammer's first defense of his newly won WBA Intercontinental Heavyweight title. The bout was also for the vacant European heavyweight title. The bout took place on the 25th of September 1999 and was scheduled for 12 rounds. Dr. Steelhammer dominated the bout for 8 rounds and then landed a straight left which sent the German giant crashing to the canvas for the first time in his career. And thus, when he got up, the referee waved the bout as he believed the German was in no fit state to continue the bout. Alex Schultz had been in the ring against George Foreman and he lost a very controversial points decision to George Foreman. It was that controversial that the IBF immediately ordered George Foreman to face the giant German again. However, George Foreman decided to vacate the IBF championship instead of fighting Alex Schultz for a second time, so Alex Schultz was a major name on Dr. Steelhammer's resume. Dr. Steelhammer's 31st professional bout came on the 12th of November 1999 in Nevada, USA against Phil Jackson. The bout was scheduled for 10 rounds, so Wladimir Klitschko's recently won titles were not on the line. Dr. Steelhammer annihilated the American by knocking him out in the second round of the fight. Dr. Steelhammer's 32nd professional bout came less than 1 month after his American outing. This time Wladimir Klitschko was back in Germany in the city of Hanover. Dr. Steelhammer was up against an Hungarian by the name of Lajos Eros. This bout was scheduled for 12 rounds and Dr. Steelhammer was defending his WBA Intercontinental and European heavyweight titles. Dr. Steelhammer knocked the Hungarian out in the second round, thus retaining his title. Dr. Steelhammer's 33rd professional bout took place in the new millennium on the 18th of March 2000 in Hamburg, Germany, and was scheduled for 12 rounds. The bout was for the vacant WBC International Heavyweight title against a Togan tough man called Pierre Wolfgram. Now, Pierre Wolfgram had a record of 18 wins and only one loss, so by no means was he a journeyman. Now, I'm sure some of you will remember that peer Wolfgram had won a silver medal at the 1996 Summer Olympics in Atlanta in the super heavyweight division. The man to beat him and capture the gold medal was, of course, Dr. Steelhammer himself. Dr. Steelhammer thrashed the Togan, knocking him out halfway through the first round and thus picking up the WBC International Heavyweight title. A title that Dr. Steelhammer had previously lost against Ross Purity. Dr. Steelhammer's 34th professional bout took place on the 29th of April 2000, so it was a little over a month after his previous bout. The location of the bout was Madison Square Gardens, New York City, United States of America. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 243 pounds and his American adversary David Bostas weighed in at 231 pounds. David, the Boss Boston, was knocked down twice in the first round and twice in the second round. After the second knockdown in the second round, the referee stopped the bout. Now, David Bostas had only one loss prior to his fight against Dr. Steelhammer, so he was by no means a journeyman. David Bostas went on to fight heavyweights such as Calvin Brock, Luan Karonansky and Alexander Povetkin. Dr. Steelhammer's 35th professional fight came against an American by the name of Monty Barrett in London, England. This was Dr. Steelhammer's first professional bout in the United Kingdom. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 244 pounds and his foe weighed in at 220 pounds. The American's record stood at 23 victories and only one defeat. So don't get it twisted, Monty Barrett was by no means a journeyman and was actually a real live solid opponent with only one defeat. Wladimir Klitschko knocked Monty Barrett down in the opening round, then Wladimir Klitschko put Monty Barrett down again in the fourth round with a combination of punches. In the seventh round, Dr. Steelhammer knocked his American adversary down three times and the referee stopped the bout. Dr. Steelhammer's 36th professional fight took place on the 14th of October 2000. The location of the bout was Cologne, Germany. This bout was extremely special as it was for the WBO heavyweight title. Dr. Steelhammer was the challenger and the champion was Chris Bryard. Chris Bryard had defeated Vitali Klitschko, Wladimir Klitschko's older brother, in his previous bout and thus had taken the WBO heavyweight title from him. Dr. Steelhammer knocked Chris Bryard down in rounds 9 and 11 and won a comfortable unanimous decision, thus becoming the new WBO heavyweight champion of the world. Dr. Steelhammer's first defense of his WBO heavyweight title came on the 24th of March 2001 in Munich, Germany against an American called Derek Jefferson. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 246 pounds and Derek Jefferson tipped the scale at 260 pounds. Dr. Steelhammer stopped the American in the second round. Dr. Steelhammer had sent Derek Jefferson to the canvas three times and he had thus retained his WBO heavyweight title. Dr. Steelhammer's second defense of his WBO heavyweight title and his 38th pro bout took place on the 4th of August and was located in Paradise, Nevada, the United States of America. Dr. Steelhammer's foe was an American by the name of Charles Shufford. Charles Shufford had a pro record of 17 wins and 1 defeat, so he was by no means a journeyman. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 241 pounds, 5 pounds less than he did against his previous opponent. While Charles Shufford weighed in at 234 pounds, Dr. Steelhammer knocked down Charles Shufford in rounds 2 and 3. Both knockdowns coming after Wladimir Klitschko landed a straight right. Dr. Steelhammer delivered a left hook in round 6 which floored the American and the referee stopped the fight. A side note, Charles Shufford's most notable performance outside of the ring came playing the role of George Foreman in the 2001 movie Ali. Dr. Steelhammer's third defense of his WBO heavyweight title and his 39th professional fight took place on the 16th of March 2002 in Stuttgart, Germany. It was against a South African by the name of Franz Botha. Now, Franz Botha had been in the ring against both Mike Tyson and Lennox Lewis. However, he came up short both times. Franz Botha had also won the IBF heavyweight title only to be stripped after a failed drugs test after the fight. The South African came to the ring with a record of 44 victories, 3 defeats and 1 draw, so he was by no means a journeyman. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 242 pounds. Dr. Steelhammer's South African opponent tipped the scales at 241 pounds, so there was just 1 pound weight difference between the two. Dr. Steelhammer won via TKO in the 8th round. Now Francis Botha would go on to share the ring against Evander Holyfield, Carlos Takam and Joseph Parker. So by no means was Franz Botha a coward as he shared the ring against many future boxing Hall of Famers. Dr. Steelhammer's 40th professional fight occurred on the 29th of June 2002 in Atlantic City, Jersey in the United States of America. Dr. Steelhammer's American adversary was the former heavyweight world champion Ray Mercer. This bout was Dr. Steelhammer's fourth defense of his WBO heavyweight title. Wladimir Klitschko weighed in at 243 pounds and Ray Mercer weighed in at 228 pounds. Ray Mercer was knocked down by 2 left hooks in the first round. Ray Mercer sustained a cut over his right eye after a hook in the 5th round. The referee called a halt to the action in the 6th round after an onslaught of unanswered power punches by Dr. Steelhammer. Dr. Steelhammer's 41st professional bout came on the 7th of December 2002 and took place in Paradise, Nevada in the United States of America. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 241 pounds and his American opponent Jameel McLean weighed in at 263 pounds. Jameel McLean had a record of 28 victories, 2 defeats and 3 draws and was undefeated in his last 28 bouts. James McLean won a unanimous decision victory over Shannon Briggs in his previous bout, so this was a potential banana skin and a real tough fight for Wladimir Klitschko. Dr. Steelhammer landed a left hook in round 10 which forced Jameel McLean's corner to throw the towel in. Now, on a side note, the rematch between Floyd Mayweather and Jose Luis Castile was on the undercard of this bout. Wladimir Klitschko's 42nd professional fight came on the 8th of March 2003 in the city of Hanover in Germany. Wladimir Klitschko was almost 27 years of age and his foe in his 6th defense of his WBO heavyweight title was a man called Corey Sanders. Corey Sanders knocked out Wladimir Klitschko 27 seconds into the second round to win the WBO heavyweight title. This fight was a major upset at the time and the fight was named Ring Magazine Upset of the Year for 2003. Dr. Steelhammer's 43rd professional bout came against an Argentinian by the name of Fabio Eduardo Molli. Now, Fabio Eduardo Molli at the time had a record of 29 victories and just 2 defeats, so he was by no means a journeyman. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 243 pounds and Fabio Eduardo Molli weighed in at 259 pounds. The bout took place on the 30th of August 2003. Dr. Steelhammer annihilated the Argentinian in the first round. Dr. Steelhammer's 44th professional bout came on the 20th of December 2003 in the city of Kiel, Germany. Dr. Steelhammer's foe was an American by the name of Daniel Nicholson. Now, Daniel Nicholson had a record of 42 wins and 4 defeats. So, Daniel Nicholson was by no means a journeyman by any stretch of the imagination. Anyway, Dr. Steelhammer went on to win a 4th round TKO victory over the American. Now, after this particular bout, Dr. Steelhammer went on to enlist the services of the legendary boxing trainer Emmanuel Steward. Dr. Steelhammer's 45th professional fight took place on the 10th of April 2004. The location of the bout was Paradise, Nevada, the United States of America. The bout was for the vacant WBO heavyweight title. Wladimir Klitschko's American adversary was a man by the name of Lamon Brewster. Now, Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 243 pounds and Lamon Brewster weighed in at 226 pounds. Dr. Steelhammer was dominating the fight with his punishing left jab and knocked Brewster down to the canvas in the 4th round with a vicious right hand. Wladimir Klitschko appeared close to being able to stop Brewster, but Brewster managed to get through the initial onslaught. Midway through the 5th round, Lamon Brewster landed the left hooks that changed the fight. Wladimir Klitschko was hurt and went into the ropes where the referee ruled a knockdown. Brewster went back after him and had him hurt and the referee stopped the fight. Shortly after the fight, Wladimir Klitschko was rushed to the hospital. The examination showed Wladimir Klitschko's blood sugar level almost 2 times higher than the permissible amount. According to Wladimir Klitschko's team, the doctor told them that Wladimir Klitschko had been inches away from falling into a diabetic coma. After returning from the examination to the hotel, Wladimir Klitschko fell ill with nausea followed by physical weakness. On the 12th of April, Dr. Steelhammer arrived in Las Vegas and donated blood and urine samples for an independent examination. The blood and urine samples showed no sign of anabolic steroids but did suggest that Wladimir Klitschko could have been poisoned. The drug has no taste or smell and causes mental disorders which are accompanied by impaired coordination, a weakening reaction, and overall physical weakness. Following the results, Wladimir Klitschko demanded the tests taken by the Medical Center of South Nevada and the Nevada Diagnostics to be passed on to Dr. Robert Wow for further research. So basically, Wladimir Klitschko was demanding the sample that the Nevada State Athletic Commission had of his due to the drug testing in this fight be handed over to Dr. Robert Wow so he can do further research on these samples. But the A sample had already been disposed of, while the B sample, which was supposed to be stored for years, had mysteriously vanished. As a result of the circumstances that surrounded the fight, the FBI started an investigation. Vladimir Klitschko's lawyer suggested that Vladimir Klitschko was a victim of the ongoing fight fixing in Las Vegas, which also included fraudulent medical reports. Many journalists pointed out that in the last 48 hours before the fight, the betting odds in favor of Wladimir Klitschko rapidly dropped. Some observers believed that such a massive drop in the betting odds was due to Don King putting a large amount of money on a Brewster victory. So, we have Wladimir Klitschko's A and B samples going missing. We have the FBI opening an investigation. We have a specialist doctor in the United States of America saying he thinks that Wladimir Klitschko was poisoned, and the cherry on top is that allegedly Don King betted a large sum of money on the underdog to win. Come to your own conclusions, people, as I don't want to say anything that could possibly have legal ramifications against me. Wladimir Klitschko also fired his cutman Joe Souza, as Joe Souza used Vaseline on Wladimir Klitschko's face and body, which he had never done before. As a replacement, Dr. Steelhammer hired Jacob Stitch Duran. Dr. Steelhammer made his comeback against an American called Dravael Williamson. The bout was located in Paradise, Nevada, the United States of America, and the date was the 2nd of October 2004. Williamson had a record of 20 victories and only 2 defeats, so it was an incredibly risky fight for Dr. Steelhammer. Williamson dropped Wladimir Klitschko 40 seconds into the second round, but Dr. Steelhammer was comfortably winning the fight by outboxing his American foe. An accidental headbutt by Williamson in the closing seconds of the fifth round left Wladimir Klitschko bleeding from a cut above his right eye. Due to the cut, the bout was prematurely stopped, with Wladimir Klitschko being declared the winner by technical decision. Dr. Steelhammer's 47th professional bout came on the 23rd of April 2005 in Dortmund, Germany. Dr. Steelhammer's challenger was a Cuban by the name of Elcio Castillo. Elcio Castillo was undefeated coming into the fight and had a record of 18 victories and 1 draw. So this was an incredibly difficult fight for Dr. Steelhammer. Now, in his previous fight, Castillo had outpointed the former world champion and the man that had defeated Evander Holyfield, Michael Moore. Dr. Steelhammer managed to stop the undefeated Cuban in the fourth round by landing a heavy straight right with 9 seconds left in the round. The Cuban managed to stagger to his feet, but the referee stopped the bout. Dr. Steelhammer's 48th professional fight came on the 24th of September 2005 in Atlantic City, New Jersey, in the United States of America. Dr. Steelhammer's foe was an undefeated Nigerian by the name of Samuel Peters. Now, this bout was an IBF eliminator, and the winner would be mandatory for the IBF champion. The first four rounds saw Dr. Steelhammer control the bout, not allowing Samuel Peters to close the distance by utilizing his jab. During the fifth round, Samuel Peters caught Wladimir Klitschko with an illegal punch to the back of the head that sent Wladimir Klitschko down onto the canvas, but the referee ruled it as a legitimate knockdown. As soon as Dr. Steelhammer got up, Samuel Peters went on the attack and yet again delivered an illegal rabbit punch to Dr. Steelhammer, and again Dr. Steelhammer hit the canvas, and yet again the referee ruled it as a legitimate knockdown. Wladimir Klitschko controlled the rest of the bout and won a clear and comfortable unanimous decision, with all of the judges scoring the bout identically at 114-111. Dr. Steelhammer's 49th fight as a professional came on the 22nd of April 2006 and took place in the city of Mannheim in Germany. Dr. Steelhammer's American adversary was the reigning, defending IBF heavyweight champion of the world, Chris Bryant. Dr. Steelhammer tipped the scales at 241 pounds. And his American adversary weighed in at 213 pounds. The vacant IBO heavyweight title was also on the line in this fight. So that's both the IBF and IBO on the line in this fight. Now, this fight was one-sided to say the least. Dr. Steelhammer delivered a right hook 41 seconds into the 7th round and the referee stopped the fight. Now, this was the second time Dr. Steelhammer had defeated Chris Bryant. Now, Chris Bryant had made 4 defenses of his IBF heavyweight title. Chris Bryant went on to face Alexander Povetkin in 2007. So, after that spectacular victory, Dr. Steelhammer was now the IBF and IBO heavyweight champion of the world. Dr. Steelhammer's first defense of his newly acquired titles and his 50th professional fight came on the 11th of November 2006. The location of the bout was Madison Square Gardens, New York City, in the United States of America. Dr. Steelhammer tipped the scales at 241 pounds and his undefeated American adversary weighed in at 224 pounds. Dr. Steelhammer's American adversary was a man called Calvin Brock, who had a record of 29 victories, 0 draws and 0 defeats. So, Dr. Steelhammer's first defense of his IBF and IBO world titles came against an incredibly dangerous fighter. Dr. Steelhammer suffered a cut over his left eye from an accidental headbutt in the 6th round. However, that didn't deter Dr. Steelhammer and he knocked Brock down in the 7th round. Calvin Brock barely beat the count, but the referee stepped in and stopped the fight as he believed Brock was in no condition to continue the contest. Now, what is interesting is that before the Brock fight, Wladimir Klitschko was supposed to face Shannon Briggs, but the deal fell through and Briggs ended up fighting another opponent. Dr. Steelhammer's 51st professional fight occurred on the 10th of March 2007 in Mannheim, Germany, against an American called Ray Austin, who was the IBF mandatory challenger. Dr. Steelhammer annihilated his American mandatory challenger with a barrage of left hooks that dropped Ray Austin, and Dr. Steelhammer knocked the American out in the 2nd round. Dr. Steelhammer's 52nd professional fight occurred on the 7th of July 2007 in Cologne, Germany, against Lamont Brewster. Lamont Brewster had bested Wladimir Klitschko, although it was under mysterious circumstances, he had nonetheless bested Wladimir Klitschko. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 243 pounds and his American adversary weighed in at 228 pounds. Dr. Steelhammer avenged his previous defeat to Brewster by defeating Brewster after Brewster's corner asked the referee to stop the bout at the end of the 6th round. It later emerged that Dr. Steelhammer had fought most of the contest with a broken middle finger on his left hand. By the end of October, Dr. Steelhammer had begun negotiations with the WBO heavyweight champion Sultan Ibragimov. This would be the first unification fight since the 13th of November 1999 when the then WBC champion Lennox Lewis defeated the then WBA and IBF champion Evander Holyfield. On the 20th of November, both fighters officially signed the contract for the unification clash to take place on the 23rd of February 2008 at Madison Square Garden. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 238 pounds and his undefeated Russian opponent, who was also the WBO heavyweight champion, weighed in at 219 pounds. The bout was a boxing masterclass by Dr. Steelhammer, who kept his opponent at distance using his dynamic jab. Dr. Steelhammer went on to win the fight via unanimous decision and thus not only retain his titles but also won the WBO heavyweight title. The bout was criticized by observers. For example, Bob Arum said the fight was an absolute shame. The bout would prove to be Sultan's last as he retired after the fight. Sultan, a former Olympic silver medalist and former WBO heavyweight champion, revealed in 2020 that his retirement was caused by chronic problems with his left hand. Now, on a side note, Sultan had defeated Shannon the Cannon Briggs for the WBO heavyweight title. Dr. Steelhammer's 54th professional bout came on the 12th of July 2008 and took place in the city of Hamburg in Germany. Dr. Steelhammer's foe was an American by the name of Tony Thompson, who was also Dr. Steelhammer's mandatory challenger. Tony Thompson had a record of 31 victories and 1 defeat. Dr. Steelhammer floored Thompson with a big right hand near the end of the 5th round, and his American adversary never recovered. Dr. Steelhammer dropped Thompson again in the 6th round and the referee stopped the fight. Dr. Steelhammer was scheduled to defend his titles against Alexander Povetkin in late 2008, but Alexander Povetkin pulled out of the fight due to injury. So, instead of Alexander Povetkin, Dr. Steelhammer faced Hashim Rahman, an American, in Mannheim, Germany on the 13th of December 2008. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 245 pounds and Hashim Rahman weighed in at 254 pounds. Now, Hashim Rahman had previously defeated Lennox Lewis and became the unified heavyweight champion of the world. Dr. Steelhammer stopped the American in the 7th round via TKO when the referee stepped in and put an end to the bout. Dr. Steelhammer had won every single round of the bout utilizing his jab with great effect. Dr. Steelhammer was scheduled to face David Haye on the 20th of June 2009, but David Haye pulled out within weeks of the scheduled fight date. Immediately after the news broke about David Haye's injury, a handful of heavyweights wanted the fight, including Alexander Povetkin, Eddie Chambers and Chaz Witherspoon. Dr. Steelhammer's team started negotiations with Ruslan Chagayev, who was ranked number 3 by The Ring magazine, and also with the gigantic Russian WBA champion Nikolayev Evaluev. Dr. Steelhammer managed to agree a deal with the undefeated Uzbekistani Ruslan Chagayev, who agreed to step in for David Haye at the last minute. The deal between Dr. Steelhammer and Nikolay Valuev's team fell through because Nikolay Valuev's team wanted the bout to occur in the autumn, thus giving their fighter more time to prepare. The fight took place on the 20th of June 2009 in the Valentins Arena in Germany. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 240 pounds, while Chagayev weighed in at 225 pounds. The undefeated Uzbek came to the ring with a record of 25 victories, of which 17 came by a knockout and 1 draw. There were over 61,000 fans in attendance, which was the largest audience for boxing in Germany since 1939. Dr. Steelhammer dominated the contest, keeping Chagayev at the end of his jab. Dr. Steelhammer floored Chagayev in the final seconds of the 2nd round. Dr. Steelhammer started gradually boxing more aggressively as the bout progressed. Chagayev's trainer did not allow him to come out for the 10th round, thus Dr. Steelhammer won via corner retirement in the 9th round. With this victory, Wladimir Klitschko added the prestigious Ring magazine heavyweight title to his magnificent collection of belts. On the 9th of December 2009, Wladimir Klitschko's management group K2 Promotions confirmed that a bout with Eddie Chambers had been agreed. Eddie Chambers was the WBO mandatory challenger. Now, what was surprising was that no United States TV channel was airing the bout. The fight took place in Dusseldorf, Germany, and Dr. Steelhammer was almost 34 years of age. This was the 8th defense of Dr. Steelhammer's IBF title. The bout was one-sided, with Dr. Steelhammer utilizing his favorite weapon in his arsenal, his jab. And Dr. Steelhammer kept Eddie Chambers at the end of his jab. In the final round, Dr. Steelhammer landed a left hook on his American adversary's temple. The punch was so powerful it caused Eddie Chambers to lose consciousness in the ring, and the referee stopped the bout. That was the only bout Eddie Chambers lost via knockout. Now, most boxing fans will have heard of Eddie Chambers in recent times because of an interesting message that Anthony Joshua sent him. Following the fight with Chambers, Dr. Steelhammer wanted a unification bout with the WBA champion David Haye, who had defeated the gigantic Russian Nikolai Valuev. Dr. Steelhammer called David Haye out personally on YouTube in April 2010, stating, "I want to send this message to boxing fans and directly to David Haye. David, you've female dogged out of fighting both Klitschko brothers twice already, and now's the time to make it happen. On behalf of all boxing fans around the world, I am officially calling you out to fight me. You can't run away from me forever, and you need to follow through with this fight. If you want to be respected, I'm ready. What are you waiting for?" Now, that was a statement by Wladimir Klitschko. This video is still available to watch on Wladimir Klitschko's official YouTube channel. Now, after wasting months negotiating with Wladimir Klitschko, David Haye said he was interested in fighting Vitali Klitschko. Spoiler alert, he didn't, and was wasting more time. So instead, Dr. Steelhammer turned his attention to his mandatory challenger, Alexander Povetkin. The bout between Dr. Steelhammer and Alexander Povetkin was scheduled to take place on the 11th of September 2010 in Frankfurt, Germany. However, Alexander Povetkin failed to show up to the press conference and decided to pull out of the fight on the advice of his trainer Teddy Atlas. So Samuel Peters was brought in to face Dr. Steelhammer. It would be the pair's second meeting, as they had previously clashed in 2005. The pair's second meeting took place on the 11th of September 2010 in Frankfurt, Germany. Dr. Steelhammer tipped the scales at a career heaviest 247 pounds, while Samuel Peters weighed in at 241 pounds. The first four rounds of the bout were pretty even, but after the fourth, it was one-way traffic. After the ninth round, Samuel Peters' trainer Abel Sanchez said he would give Peters one more round before pulling him out. In the 10th round, Dr. Steelhammer delivered a conclusive combination that put Peters down and the referee called a halt to the action. So, Dr. Steelhammer won via 10th round knockout. On the 5th of January 2011, it was announced that Derek Chisora would be Dr. Steelhammer's next adversary. This enraged David Hayes trainer Adam Booth, who described the move as a disgrace. Adam Booth also alleged that David Hay had met every single one of Wladimir Klitschko's demands. The fight between Chisora and Dr. Steelhammer was scheduled for the 30th of April 2011 and was set to take place in Mannheim, Germany. However, on the 4th of March, it was announced that Wladimir Klitschko had pulled out of the fight due to an injury. On the 5th of March, it was announced that the highly anticipated fight against David Hay would take place on the 2nd of July 2011. The fight was contingent on Dr. Steelhammer's recovery from his injury, which was a torn abdominal muscle. The contract was written so that if Dr. Steelhammer wasn't fully healed, then David Hay would fight his older brother and the WBC champion Vitali Klitschko. The bout took place on the 2nd of July 2011 in Hamburg, Germany. David Hay had been sparring the undefeated David Price in preparation for the bout. Wladimir Klitschko and David Hay had agreed on a 50-50 purse split, and David Hay was allotted 7,000 seats for his travelling fans. David Hay came into the ring with a record of 25 victories and just one defeat. The opening rounds were cagey, with David Hay standing off and looking for an opportunity, and Dr. Steelhammer trying to pin David Hay down with his favourite weapon, his jab. Dr. Steelhammer dominated the bout, outlanding David Hay in every round except the fourth. Dr. Steelhammer comfortably won a unanimous decision victory over the Brit. David Hay revealed in the press conference following the fight that he had a broken toe on his right foot. David Hay claimed that his broken pinky toe had hindered his game plan, as he had intended to jump out at Wladimir Klitschko and punch him, but was unable to do so due to his injury. David Hay was ridiculed by boxing journalists and fans alike for citing his toe as the reason why he lost the bout. Boxing journalists and fans would dub this Toegate. After defeating David Hay and winning his WBA heavyweight title, all of the major heavyweight titles were in the hands of the Klitschko family. Wladimir and Vitali Klitschko became the first and only pair of brothers to simultaneously hold all of the major heavyweight titles. This period of Klitschko dominance over the heavyweight division is dubbed as the Klitschko era. On the 6th of October 2011, Wladimir Klitschko announced his next fight would be on the 10th of December 2011 against the former unified cruiserweight champion Jean-Marc Mormek. The fight was set to take place in Dusseldorf, Germany. However, on the 5th of December, the fight was cancelled because Wladimir Klitschko checked into a hospital to have kidney stones removed. After the surgery, Wladimir Klitschko suffered from a fever and inflammation. The fight was rescheduled for the 3rd of March 2012. The bout took place in Dusseldorf, Germany, and it took place just 6 days after Dr. Steelhammer's 36th birthday. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 245 pounds and his French foe tipped the scales at 216 pounds. Now, Mormek hadn't fought in 15 months and landed just 3 punches in the whole fight. Mormek earned $600,000 for the fight or $200,000 for each punch he threw. Dr. Steelhammer knocked out the former unified cruiserweight champion in the 4th round and thus won his 60th fight as a professional. On the 7th of July 2012, Dr. Steelhammer faced his IBF mandatory challenger in Tony Thompson. Dr. Steelhammer had already bested Tony Thompson in the past. The bout took place in Bern, Switzerland, and during the 6th round, Dr. Steelhammer delivered a combination to the American that sent him to the canvas. Tony Thompson got up but had to hold on to the ropes for support, and thus the referee put a stop to the action. On the 25th of October, Dr. Steelhammer's trainer and legendary boxing coach Emmanuel Stewart passed away. So, of course, rest in peace, Emmanuel Stewart. Now, on a side note to newer boxing fans, Emmanuel Stewart is the uncle of Tyson Fury's current trainer, Javon Sugar Hill. On the 10th of November 2012, Dr. Steelhammer stepped in the ring against an unbeaten Polish man called Mariusz Wack. Mariusz Wack entered the ring with a record of 27 victories and 0 defeats. 15 of his victories came via knockout. Mariusz Wack is taller than Wladimir Klitschko and had a longer reach, so of course this brought an interesting element to the fight as Wladimir Klitschko would be outreached and may not be able to rely on his jab. The bout took place in Hamburg, Germany, and Dr. Steelhammer's new coach was a man called Jonathan Banks, who was one of Emmanuel Stewart's disciples. Dr. Steelhammer won a comfortable unanimous decision victory over his formerly undefeated Polish opponent. On the 4th of May, Dr. Steelhammer faced an undefeated Italian with a record of 28-0. The Italian did have one draw on his record. The bout took place in Mannheim, Germany. Now, from the start of the bout, Dr. Steelhammer dismantled the undefeated Italian, stopping him in the 6th round. Wladimir Klitschko's next opponent was his mandatory challenger Alexander Povetkin. However, the two teams failed to reach an agreement and thus purse bids were called. Alexander Povetkin's promoter bid $6 million and Dr. Steelhammer's promoter bid just over $7 million. But both bids were dwarfed by the colossal bid by promoter Wladimir Hurganov, who bid over $23 million. With all of that money coming from the Russian businessman Andrei Rybinsky. The victory allowed Rybinsky to choose the location of the fight and guaranteed both fighters their biggest career purses. Dr. Steelhammer received $17.5 million while Alexander Povetkin, the WBA mandatory, received $5.8 million. The bout took place on the 5th of October 2013 in the Olympic Stadium in Moscow in Russia. Alexander Povetkin came to the ring with a record of 26 victories and no defeats. The bout was marred with over 160 clinches, most of them were initiated by Wladimir Klitschko. Wladimir Klitschko was accused of deploying bully tactics throughout the fight. Dr. Steelhammer did what he needed to do in the fight and won via unanimous decision. It wasn't glamorous, it wasn't beautiful. I mean, some of the tactics deployed by Wladimir Klitschko would have been more suited in the WWE. Wladimir Klitschko did the most important thing on the night, which was he won the contest by any means necessary. Dr. Steelhammer's 65th professional bout took place on the 26th of April 2014 in Germany. Dr. Steelhammer's foe was a Samoan-born Australian heavyweight who was also his WBO mandatory challenger. The name of Dr. Steelhammer's foe was Alex Leopai. Dr. Steelhammer tipped the scales at 247 pounds while his Australian adversary weighed in at 248 pounds. The bout was a one-sided affair with Dr. Steelhammer knocking his foe down three times before the referee called a halt to the action. The IBF ordered Dr. Steelhammer to face Kerber Pulev, who was their mandatory challenger. A purse bid was called on the 17th of June, which was won by Dr. Steelhammer's promotional company K2 Promotions with a winning bid of $7.25 million. 2 days before the fight, it was revealed that only the IBF heavyweight title would be at stake for Kerber Pulev, and if Dr. Steelhammer lost, the rest of his belts would be vacated. This can be seen very simply as a cost-cutting measure by Kerber Pulev, as he didn't wish to pay the sanctioning fees for all of the belts. The Bulgarian brute Kerber Pulev came into the bout with a record of 20 victories and no defeats. The Bulgarian was an incredibly dangerous foe for Dr. Steelhammer. However, as we know, Dr. Steelhammer made the greatest of challenges appear powerless. And the undefeated Bulgarian was no different. Dr. Steelhammer knocked Pulev down three times before knocking him out in the fifth round. The bout had taken place in Hamburg, Germany on the 15th of November 2014. Dr. Steelhammer's 67th fight as a professional came on the 25th of April 2015 in Madison Square Gardens, New York City, in the United States of America. Dr. Steelhammer was 39 years of age by this point in his career, and his American adversary was an undefeated man by the name of Bryant Jennings. Bryant Jennings entered the ring with a record of 19 victories and 0 defeats. Dr. Steelhammer weighed in at 241 pounds while his American adversary weighed in at 227 pounds. Dr. Steelhammer dominated the bout and won via unanimous decision. Dr. Steelhammer broke many records this night, including Joe Louis's record of most opponents defeated in title fights at heavyweight. He also broke Muhammad Ali and Jose Naples' record of 14 wins in unified heavyweight title bouts. Wladimir Klitschko was scheduled to face the undefeated heavyweight Tyson Fury, who was also his WBO mandatory on the 24th of October 2015. But the bout was postponed due to Wladimir Klitschko picking up a calf injury. The bout was rescheduled for the 28th of November 2015. The bout would take place in Dusseldorf, Germany, and Wladimir Klitschko weighed in at 246 pounds. While the undefeated Brit tipped the scales 1 pound heavier at 247 pounds. On the night of the bout, there was considerable controversy, first starting with the gloves, then came the ring canvas complaints, then of course there was the hand wrapping incident, where allegedly Wladimir Klitschko had his hands wrapped without a representative of Tyson Fury present. So, allegedly Wladimir Klitschko had his hands wrapped all over again. Tyson Fury came into the fight with a height and reach advantage over Wladimir Klitschko. Tyson Fury had 4 more inches of reach than Wladimir Klitschko and was also 3 inches taller than his adversary. The Brit came to the ring with a record of 25 victories, 18 of them coming via knockout, and no defeats. The fight itself was a dull affair, with both fighters showing little offense during the bout, with Tyson Fury doing enough to take the decision. It was Wladimir Klitschko's first defeat in over a decade. Now, Wladimir Klitschko wasn't going to lick his wounds, and he had a rematch clause in place. The rematch was eventually announced on the 8th of April 2016 and was set to take place in Tyson Fury's hometown of Manchester. The venue of the bout would be the Manchester Arena, and the date would have been the 9th of July 2016. However, Tyson Fury announced via a YouTube video that the fight would be postponed due to an ankle sprain he had suffered during training. On the 7th of July, Tyson Fury announced via his Twitter account that the rescheduled fight would take place on the 29th of October 2016. On the 23rd of September, Tyson Fury again postponed the fight after he was declared medically unfit. Tyson Fury then vacated the WBA Super, the WBO and IBO heavyweight world titles. Tyson Fury cited problems with depression after testing positive for cocaine. The rematch between Tyson Fury and Wladimir Klitschko was cancelled as a result. Days after the Tyson Fury rematch was called off, Wladimir Klitschko was approached by Eddie Hearn, the promoter of the IBF champion Anthony Joshua. He made an offer to Wladimir Klitschko for Wladimir Klitschko to fight Anthony Joshua on the 28th of November. Terms seemed to have been agreed. Although the contract for the £30 million showdown had yet to be signed. On October the 24th, Wladimir Klitschko suffered a minor calf injury which would rule him out until 2017. Talks between Wladimir Klitschko's team and Eddie Hearn remained active, with the bout set to take place in the first half of 2017. On the 10th of December, immediately after Anthony Joshua had defeated Eric Monila, Wladimir Klitschko was invited into the ring by Eddie Hearn, where it was announced that Anthony Joshua would face Wladimir Klitschko for Joshua's IBF world title and the vacant IBO and WBA super heavyweight titles. The WBO heavyweight belt was in the possession of a New Zealander by the name of Joseph Parker. Wladimir Klitschko's 69th professional bout took place on the 29th of April 2017. The venue of the bout was Wembley Stadium in London, England, in the United Kingdom. 90,000 tickets had been sold for the bout, which was a new box office record, overtaking Carl Froch vs. George Groves 2. Wladimir Klitschko weighed in at 240 pounds, the lightest he had weighed in at since 2009. Meanwhile, the undefeated British fighter Anthony Joshua weighed in at 250 pounds. Anthony Joshua came to the ring with a record of 18 victories and no losses, all of Joshua's 18 victories coming via knockout. During the first four rounds of the bout, both fighters were very, very cautious. In the fifth round, Joshua came out and threw a barrage of punches, knocking Wladimir Klitschko down. An angry Wladimir Klitschko got off the canvas and proceeded to dominate Joshua for the rest of the round. During the sixth round, Wladimir Klitschko landed a heavy right hand, sending Joshua to the canvas. Dr. Steelhammer was dominating the bout and was clearly the ring general. However, in round 11, Anthony Joshua landed a lucky punch from the gods, which would change the bout completely. The lucky punch was, of course, the uppercut. Joshua then delivered a few small but powerful combinations, which sent Wladimir Klitschko to the canvas. Wladimir Klitschko rose up off the canvas but was then knocked down a second time in the round after Joshua landed a seven-punch combination. Wladimir Klitschko again got up and Anthony Joshua delivered a barrage of unanswered shots, so the referee called a halt to the action. There was a rematch clause in the contract, however, on the 3rd of August 2017, Wladimir Klitschko announced on his official website and social media channels that he was retiring from boxing. And thus he ended his career with 69 fights and 64 victories, of which 53 of those victories came via knockout. Throughout his career, Wladimir Klitschko defeated 23 boxers for the World Heavyweight Championship, breaking an all-time record that belonged to Joe Louis. Dr. Steelhammer holds several historical records, including the longest combined heavyweight world championship reign in history, at 4,382 days, which is 12 years. The most victories in world heavyweight title bouts since the international expansion of heavyweight boxing at 25 wins. The most wins in unified title bouts with 15. And the longest unified championship reign in professional boxing with 14 consecutive defenses. Dr. Steelhammer has the second most total successful title defenses in heavyweight history, with 23 behind Joe Louis, who has 25, and ahead of Larry Holmes, who has 20, and Muhammad Ali, who has 19. Dr. Steelhammer fought in 29 world title fights, more than any other heavyweight in boxing history. As of September 2020, BoxRec ranks Wladimir Klitschko as the 17th greatest pound for pound of all time, the third greatest heavyweight of all time, and the second greatest European pound for pound fighter of all time. Dr. Steelhammer also holds the record of having defeated the most boxers, with an undefeated record of which he defeated 12. Dr. Steelhammer also defeated 9 current or former world champions throughout his lengthy career. These 9 include heavyweights Chris Bryant, who Wladimir Klitschko defeated twice, Ray Mercer, Lamont Brewster, Samuel Peters, Sultan, Hashim Rahman, Ruslan Chagayev, and two-way world champion David Haye, as well as the former Cruiserweight Unified World Champion Jean-Marc Mormek. So that was Wladimir Klitschko's illustrious career.